Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain speaking. We are currently experiencing some turbulence, and until we move into clear weather, please keep your seatbelts fastened and your seats in an uptight position.
A great paragram.
Great what?
A paragram. Your paragram. Very clever.
What's a paragram?
Oh, what you just did.
What did I do?
The changing of one or more letters of an expression to create humor or irony. That's a paragram.
I didn't do that.
You said keep your seats in an uptight position instead of upright position.
I said upright.
No, you didn't.
Are you serious? Did I really say uptight?
Wait, you didn't mean to say that?
No.
Oh, then that's a malapropism.
A mala what?
An absurd or humorous misuse of a word, especially by confusion with one of a similar sound. Not a paragram at all.
Oh my God, these people are going to think I'm an idiot. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain again. Please keep your seats up tight against you and in an upright position until we've moved into clear weather. I hope this makes my previous announcement clear.
Blasphemy!
What?
The association of one word with two distinct meanings.
Two meanings? What are you talking about?
You use clear twice. Once to mean free from bad weather, and again to mean easily understood. Very clever.
Why do you keep doing that?
Doing what?
Whatever you're doing.
Oh, I'm admiring your rhetoric.
Well, stop.
Don't you like praise?
Well, it's not unwelcome, but...
Lightities! Expressing the affirmative by the negative of its contrary. Very good.
Oh my God, I forgot to switch off the intercom. The passengers heard every word of that. You're making me look like a fool.
What's going on up here? You're freaking everyone out.
This idiot won't stop commenting on my language. And every time he comments on my language, he makes me look like the idiot.
Jesus! A form of inverted parallelism where two clauses are reversed!
Listening to you is making me lose control of the plane, as well as my mind!
Zoogma, the use of a verb to modify two different words in two different senses!
What in the world are you on about?
Oh, his rhetoric, what he's doing is brilliant!
I'm not doing anything! Trying to keep us safe is the only thing I'm doing!
Anastrophe! The inversion of the usual order of words or clauses!
Stop that nonsense! Stop it now! Stop me and help me fly this plane!
Anaphora! The deliberate repetition of the first part!
God damn it, Marvin! This is too hard! I can't pull this up on my own!
Oh, now we're moving into wordplay? Double entendre!
Pull on your control column! Marvin, mirror my motions!
Alliteration!
We're about to lose pitch! Do what I do! Pull up if I pull up!
A palindrome!
Huh?
Pull up if I pull up, it reads the same backwards and forwards.
No, it doesn't.
Now, do it now!
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't. And even if it did, it would be an anagram.
No, a palindrome.
Anagram.
Palindrome.
Marvin, please. I can't do this on my own.
Able I was ere I saw Elba. Palindrome. No X in Nixon, palindrome.
There is an X in Nixon.
Oh, I know there's an X in Nixon.
Then why say there wasn't.
Sweet mother of God, we're gonna die!
It's right in the middle. N-I-X-O-N.
Oh, I wasn't really saying there's no X in Nixon.
Then what were you saying?
I was giving an example of a palindrome.
It doesn't matter. Like I said, pull up when I pull up doesn't read the same forwards and backwards.
You got it wrong.
Oh, really? Spell it out. When spelled backwards is nue.
If. He said if. Pull up if I pull up.
If. When. Whatever. Just pull up.
Spell it out with me. Pull-up is the same backwards and forwards, right? P-U-L-L-U-P. And that's on both sides of the sentence. The middle part is simply if I.
Okay, so, yeah. If you use if and not when, it's an anagram.
Palindrome.
Anagram.
Wait, I'll look up the definition on my phone.
This is the end. This is the end.
Oh. Can't you keep this plane steady? I'm trying to prove a point here.
Oh, always. Mr. Cleverboots, you always have to prove you're right.
Look, an anagram is when you rearrange the letters in a word like, I don't know, give me a word.
Nixon.
Great Lord above, please commend me to your spirit.
A different word.
Oh, why a different?
Because you can't make an anagram of Nixon.
Oh, why not? Because there's no X in it?
Oh, why do you keep going on about that X?
Oh, because you think you're so smart, but you're not.
And forgive me my trespasses.
Oh, wait, oxen. That works.
Oxen? What's that?
An anagram for Nixon.
No, what does it mean?
As I forgive those who have trespassed against me.
What do you mean? What does it mean? I don't know. An inn where your ox stays for the night.
Oh, why would you keep your ox in an inn? Besides, the anagram for Nixon is when you spell it backwards. Noxon.
Oh, that's not an anagram for Nixon? Oh, actually it is, technically speaking, except it's not a word.
Why does it have to be a word?
Because it does. You just can't make up your own rules about these things.
Deliver me from evil.
Deliver me from evil, not a palindrome. Live not on evil, palindrome.
Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your captain again. Yeah, we seem to be having been through that bout of turbulence uptight. I mean, all right. It's all right. all right. All right.
Epiphany! The repetition of entire phrases. Ha! The man is a genius!
After the failure of Bunker Hill, a committee was formed consisting of Robert Livingston, Richard Sherman, Ben Franklin, and myself, with the mission of drafting a document declaring our independence from the British Crown. But while we had the legal knowledge to make something iron, we lacked what Franklin would call a certain flair. He's late.
He'll be here.
You and I alone could write the damn thing. We don't need theatrical Virginians muddying the thing up with Shakespearean histrionics.
Listen to yourself. We want to shake England to the core, not put them to sleep. We're men of law. He's an artist, a writer.
What has he written?
The Bible.
Oh, God, Ben, he hasn't even written anything.
He wrote his own adaptation of the Bible. It's a modern take.
How does one do a modern take of the Bible?
You write the same thing, just remove all the magic.
So he's an editor?
No, for God's sakes.
He took something that previously existed and just removed content?
Yes.
Then he's an editor.
Not an editor.
I could have done that, you know. I could write Oedipus without all the mother and son.
Whoa there. Not to put you down, John, but nobody likes you. You don't have a way with the language, and everyone you speak to hates you. You wouldn't woo a cat in heat.
If I didn't need a drink a minute ago, I definitely do now.
Stop being so cynical. I can vouch for him. He's a friend of mine.
That's what scares me.
Here he is.
Gentlemen, I hope you don't mind my tardiness. The ale here is abysmal. Waitress, can I get a glass? Ben, good to see you. Mr. Adams, we have not been formally introduced. I am Thomas Jefferson. I'm quite partial to the Virginian girls myself, but there certainly is a spunk to the Philadelphian class of women. So, your declaration.
Yes, Tom, we believe it's important.
It's garbage.
What?
The declaration is garbage.
Now, hold on. We put all we have into that rough draft, Ben and I. You can't just walk in and tear it down.
No, I apologize. I wasn't clear. Ben's contributions were acceptable. Yours were garbage. It's a heaping mess of tension and legal talk. You boys don't get it. This isn't just some declaration of war. For the first time since the fall of Caesar, we are witnessing the reemergence of democracy, of republicanism. The question of what a man is naturally entitled to is being determined in our lifetime. It's not simply enough to tell England to go to hell. You've got to invigorate the people. Get them to face down the British army like the Spartans did at Thermopylae. Hopefully with better results. The document cannot be simply drafted into legalese. It has to be a work of high drama, of literature.
A coup de theater.
Yes, exactly. In order to make such a work, you would need someone with an advanced knowledge of philosophy, history, of literature. You would need someone who is a theologian, an artist, a genius, and remarkably handsome. So yes, I'll do it.
Oh, thank God.
We thank you again for your services, Tom.
But I have some conditions.
Of course you do.
Right. What are your demands?
Well, firstly, due to the nature of this document, I will need to take out some insurance. So for the time being, I request that my authorship remain anonymous until hopefully we have won the war.
Done.
I also want to draw from several sources, the Scottish Enlightenment, Montesquieu, and most importantly, the works of John Locke. His perspective on the entitlement to life, liberty, and property is essential to my vision.
As long as the committee is able to review and approve the final draft, you can use whatever source you like.
Last, and this is a big last, I wish to have the document condemn slavery.
Well, we just lost Georgia.
John.
We just lost Georgia, Virginia, and the Carolinas. Are you crazy?
It's important to me.
You write that and we're screwed.
Maybe we should take a breather, huh?
Can I get a drink? Maybe three? How about a rope to hang myself?
Are you done?
Jefferson, you are a pompous jackass and I hate you. Now I'm done.
Tom. The issue of slavery is important to all of us.
If we are to decide the inherent right to freedom of all men, then it must include all men, or else we shall run the risk of a nation being born with the original sin of slavery.
Wait a minute. Aren't you the largest slave owner in Virginia, and you want to march around like an antebellum Moses?
We're all hypocrites, Mr. Adams. Some of us can just look in the mirror and recognize it when we see it.
I can't believe this.
The problem is we have to tread carefully. In order to ensure independence, the colonies must be fully united on the matter. We cannot proceed with just a two-thirds majority, or even a narrow majority. If even one colony were to vote against independence, then that is a weakness that our enemy can take advantage of. We must indeed all hang together, or we shall hang all separately.
And what of you, Mr. Adams?
There is nothing I'd want more than to end this wretched industry, but we must win the war first before we can take on something so immense that will surely be partisan. I assure you, if we make it through this, we will address the issue.
No, you won't. The moment we are on our own, every colony will hang on the word of what we say here and now in this document. But then the bureaucrats will have taken over, the issue will get kicked down the road until one day we can no longer ignore it. And when that day comes, God help us, because this sin can only be cleansed in blood.
If you are so adamant about using the writings of John Locke, then use the line about life, liberty, and property, but replace property with pursuit of happiness and assure that all men are born equal. Subtlety of unspecified race caters to your goal. It'll cause a headache, but ultimately we can use it as an argument for emancipation.
Mr. Adams, I do believe you have a poet's heart. It seems I cannot bargain any further, but your reasoning is sound. I shall start tomorrow.
Thank the Lord. This calls for a celebration, friends. Drinks. Drinks all around.
It's funny.
What?
You pretend to be so cold and calculating, and yet just then you showed your true passion.
I just believe in efficiency.
You believe in more than that, Mr. Adams. Embrace that passion and fight to keep it. Such earnestness is rare, and only those capable of seizing on it tend to go far. I find you to be quite abysmal to drink with, but I think you will be most intriguing to work with.
And thus began the revolution, and all was well then and after. No, definitely not. Jefferson was right that America would inherit an original sin. It would be another 100 years before the issue of slavery was resolved, and it would not conclude until the bloodiest war in American history left a nation in shambles and an American president assassinated. And long since then, we struggle with failures that fly in the face of our definition of liberty. Racism, sexism, classism. We've practically come to blows over whether or not you have the right to love who you want to love and be who you want to be. Fascism is always on the horizon. We've had 47 economic recessions, numerous pandemics, and 111 wars. So what do we have to be proud of? What do we have going for us? For one thing, the defeat of England assured principles of a self-governed society would remain a cornerstone of democracy. Federalism, religious freedom, the women's right movement, the public school system are all ours. We are known as the great melting pot of various races, religions, and cultures. We've made numerous advancements in science and technology. A 2019 poll showed that the United States is the single most charitable and giving nation in the world. We have evolved and changed as a people faster than any nation in such a short amount of time. So for all the arguments of when we were great or if we were forever great, that's not the question that should be asked. We've always been a nation that has been better than what we were before. The question that has to be asked, that deserves to be asked, is not if we are great, but will we be great? Can the Declaration's words ring true? I would provide you with an answer, but the question is still being asked.
Prunella, it's so good to see you.
Oh, you too, Martin.
Prunella, how I've been saying your name. Prunella, Prunella, Prunella. Oh, like prunes with vanilla.
Oh, Martin. I can't think of anything equivalent to say.
How long has it been?
Oh, it's been a long time.
Oh, it's been a long time, hasn't it, Prunella? Prunella, Prunella.
Oh, yes, 10 years, ever since our divorce.
Oh, that dreadful day. We had a particularly contentious divorce, too, didn't we? Swearing, crying, hurling accusations. I said so many awful things. You said so many awful things. Then you got all our possessions, and the house, and the kids, and the car.
Oh, I know. We really hated one another then. As a matter of fact, we've continued hating one another until, well, just yesterday. that chance meeting on the street.
Oh, it's true, Prunella. When I saw you yesterday, the sunlight shimmering off your wig, all of a sudden, all the hate and anger fell into perspective, and I thought, I love this woman. I always have loved this woman. I mean, who cares who got what in the settlement? Those are only things.
Oh, yes. My things.
All right. But the point is, Prunella, after 10 years of hating you, suddenly that hate has lifted, and in its place is, well, it's corny to say it, but in its place is love.
Oh, I feel the same way, Martin. The kids are grown, the car is broken, the house needs repair, but, well, our love for one another is real.
Prunella, I know this is crazy, and the last thing either of us thought would ever happen, but I think we should get back together. I want us to remarry.
Oh. Hello, my name is Midge, and I will be your waitress for this evening. Let me tell you about our specials, and then I'll take a cocktail order.
Could you come back in a minute?
What?
I'm sorry. Oh, would you come back in a minute? I was in the middle of a thought. Now, where was I?
Oh, Martin, it's amazing that you feel this way because I absolutely feel the same.
Oh, you do?
Oh, yes. I haven't felt anything like this in years.
We got duck and chicken and fish, all almondine.
I'm not ready now.
Well, my name is Midge, and I am your waitress.
My name is Martin, and I'm not ready.
Well, when you're ready, let me know, okay?
Oh, yes, Midge.
I'll be waiting.
Now, what was I saying?
Oh, dear. I forget.
Oh, I hate when that happens. Well, let me tell you more about my feelings, then. Stop me if you've heard it before. I feel so thoroughly renewed, young, in love. I think I'm developing a canker sore.
What?
Yes, right on my inner cheek.
Oh.
Ow, it hurts when I put my tongue on it.
Well, don't put your tongue on it then.
Oh, I have to, it hurts.
When did you get it, darling?
I don't know, it just happened.
Oh, darling, I'm sorry.
Did y'all order drinks?
No, we didn't.
Well, somebody did, and I don't wonder who it was. Oh. No. No. No.
Oh, go on, dear. I'm listening.
I was saying I feel so alive, so renewed. Oh, damn it, Prunella. This canker sore is just hurting. It's sitting in my mouth and it's hurting me.
Well, maybe you could drink something. Is there anything that you could provide for a drink that might make a canker sore feel better?
Grapefruit juice?
Oh, better not work.
Oh.
I'm not sure if we have grapefruit juice. We have mimosas, but somebody said the grapefruit juice tasted like orange juice. I'll go check.
Don't forget your pad.
I'll go check.
I don't want grapefruit juice, Midge. I'm becoming very sorry we've come to this restaurant.
Oh, now, Martin, please don't let this ruin our evening.
Are you telling me what to do already?
Well, it's just a suggestion. Don't be angry.
I'm not angry. I'm just coping with a canker sore.
More like a cranker sore.
What?
Cranker, cranky, they sound alike. I was just noticing.
Oh, canker, cranky, they don't sound particularly alike.
Anchor, anky. Well, they're more alike than, say, cranker and geranium.
Oh, this is becoming a stupid conversation.
Well, I'm very sorry that I brought it up.
Oh, this really hurts.
Well, don't keep feeling it then.
Oh, it's hard not to.
Oh, well, suit yourself. So, you think we should get married again?
What? Oh, yes, I do.
Did I leave my pad here? Oh, well, I don't know how you expect me to remember anything if I don't have my pad.
We don't expect anything from you except service.
Well, that's expecting something.
Martin, we are getting distracted and letting petty things interrupt our wonderful reconciliation. Let's not do that. Oh!
What is it?
Oh, something's in my eye. Oh, dear. Oh, my, it stings just dreadfully.
I don't understand. Something just flew into your eye.
Well, I'm not making it up. Oh, dear.
Must you say ow? It sounds peculiar.
Well, it hurts. Ow.
Oh, I believe it hurts. It just seems peculiar to have to be so vocal about it. Seems unnecessary.
Don't try to control my pain. It's my pain.
Here's your grapefruit juice.
I didn't order grapefruit juice.
Well, I wrote it down.
I don't care what you wrote down. I don't want it.
Do you want a mimosa?
Do you have an eye cup?
What?
To rinse my eye.
I can get a shot glass.
Oh, yes, please.
Well, my canker sore hurts too. Especially when I touch it.
Oh, it's not a contest, Martin.
Oh, you always get this way when there are difficulties.
Oh, it's called an appropriate response, Martin. My eye hurts.
Oh, here's the shot glass.
Oh, I don't want to get remarried again. It was a stupid idea. Life is nothing but pain and misery. It's stupid to have even thought about trying to look for something to work out.
Oh, Martin, you're overreacting. Eventually I'll get this thing out of my eye, and eventually your canker sore will leave.
Oh, it doesn't matter. Something else awful will happen.
Oh, well, fine. I'm remembering what being married to you was like.
Oh, he's right. You get your hopes up and something awful happens. I got a call last week from representatives of Mr. Ed McMahon. They said I won $1 million. And I thought, I'm going to quit my job as a waitress. But I misheard them. They said I might win $1 million if I agreed to subscribe to some magazine. So I ordered TV Guide for 36 weeks. And then, last night, my apartment got robbed, and I don't even have a TV anymore. But I'm going to get TV Guide for 36 weeks.
Well, that's too bad. I wonder if you could not talk to us so much this evening.
What?
Martin!
Well, I didn't realize when I came in here this was one of those talky chatty restaurants.
Oh, what?
I would like to have a conversation with my ex-wife. But with you, I would like to say hello and goodbye. And here's my order, please.
Oh, you'd like to order now? Well, he's difficult to understand.
Oh, I'm not difficult to understand. I would like some politeness and decorum with the people whose work it is to serve me.
Oh, just a check, please.
What?
Martin, I remembered why I divorced you. You're really horrible. You should be in therapy.
I'd love to be in therapy, but I just can't afford it.
Oh, where's the manager? I want this woman fired.
Oh, dear. I'm going to a fast food restaurant.
Oh, where's the manager, please?
I don't know if we even have a manager. You want to see the cook?
Oh, forget it. Forget it. Life is hopeless. You've ruined my remarriage.
Yeah, big deal.
hell?
It's still coming down. Some of those drifts are a yard deep already. What's the matter?
Nothing. I just wondered what happened to you.
Got scared, huh?
No, I wasn't scared. The food's all ready. Do you really think they'll make it up here in all this?
Joe's got those new chains on the car. The ones that Sandy made him fork out for? Just what'd you expect from Miss Rationality?
Right. Mr. Listmaker. Mr. My pencils have to be in the right order on my desk. No, you're not rational. Sandy is rational.
What about the TV?
Nothing. Not a thing.
The electricity's on. You'd think with a satellite dish we'd pick up something.
The telephone's still out.
They've probably been trying us on their cell since they left the city.
There's no radio either.
No radio?
Isn't it great? It's just like an Agatha Christie.
Thanks for that. I'm still not used to it being so remote. Nature's always scared the living hell out of me. Now I'm living in it. Or visiting it on the weekends, anyway. You know, I saw a bat flapping around out there. I didn't know there were bats in snowstorms. No radio. The world could be ending out there, for Christ's sake, and we'd be the last ones to hear about it. No radio.
We have no radio, and a beautiful blizzard, and a house, and woods, and a mountain that are all ours.
All ours in 29 years and 3 months.
I kind of wish they weren't coming up tonight. It's so cozy, I wouldn't mind curling up with a book.
I wish you hadn't said Agatha Christie.
Oh my god, you inflict torture on a 1, 2, and 3 on people and I can't say Agatha Christie?
Those are movies, not a real house in the middle of the real country with the lion's den. And Torturama paid for our little mansion on a hill, babe.
You know what it is about murder mysteries? No, listen. I think the reason people like murder mysteries is that in a murder mystery, everything is significant. The people in murder mysteries are living in a significant world, a world where everything is there for a reason. Even before the murders happened, you know that one is going to happen, and you know that everything is a clue. Or rather, you know that some things are clues and some things are just obfuscation. They're snow. And you know that everybody has a secret of some kind. A secret that's like a soul. Murder mysteries are religious in a way. Don't laugh. They're like the way you feel when you're in love, when everything's in a special light. There are a couple hours of everything meaning something, for God's sake. And then they're over. And you're back to your old life, to real life, to mortgages and pork loin and potatoes and making rhubarb pie.
Real life doesn't feel like it means something these days?
Oh, sure it does. I'm just saying. Well, don't we all wish for that in real life? One of those moments where everything feels charged with meaning, when the air is electric?
Well, here's your opportunity. Listen, we're probably going to be totally snowed in. Why don't we all do something different this weekend?
Different? What does different mean?
Oh, I don't know. Something unusual. Something unexpected. Not you and Sandy holding yourself up in the kitchen and talking about whatever it is you talk about. Not me and Joe sitting around talking about mom and dad. What happened in the third grade. Not the usual pour a glass of Jack Daniels. Bullshit, bullshit, bullshit. What have you guys been doing? Go into dinner and break out the Margot 01. Have you seen any movies? Did you catch that episode of blah, blah, blah? I don't know. Something we've never done before. Or let's talk about something we've never talked about before. Anything instead of all the things we usually talk about.
Okay. Something unusual. It's a deal.
Hello, Neil.
Oh.
There they are.
Hello, Neil and Jenny, right? Sorry for the cold hands. I'm freezing. God, you're just like Joe and Sandy described you. I can't believe I'm finally meeting you. Neil, I am such a fan of Torturama. All of them. Natasha can't watch them herself. Natasha is squeamish.
I'm sorry, I don't understand.
Salim, Natasha,
Hello, I'm so happy to encounter you at last. And you, Jenny, you are just as beautiful as Sandy told me. You are exquisite.
And God, what a place up here. But so remote. Wow. Oh, we brought this for you. Here, a little housewarming gift.
Whoa. I'm sorry. Maybe there's been a mistake.
I mean, this is the place, isn't it? You're Neil and Jenny. Oh, right. Where are Joe and Sandy? Middle of a snowstorm, two strange people walk in, you're spooked. Totally natural. Natasha?
Joe and Sandy couldn't make it, so they sent us instead.
They sent you instead? Wait a minute, they sent you instead?
They caught some kind of bug. God, Joe and Sandy have been telling us about you two for I don't know how long.
A long time.
A very long time.
I don't think Joe and Sandy ever mentioned knowing
Salim
and a Natasha.
You've been out of touch with your brother for far too long, brother. They were really broken up. They couldn't make it tonight. I'd say call them up, but hey, are your phones as dead as ours up here?
How do you know Joe and Sandy?
You know what's in here? Just for showing us your hospitality. It's this new tequila. $100 a bottle. Olay, right? Let's support those oppressed brothers churning this stuff out for 10 cents a day. Neil, you want to pour?
You didn't answer me.
How do we know Joe and Sandy?
How do we know them, Natasha?
Intimately.
Intimately. Good word. We know them intimately.
Neil.
Look, I'm very sorry, but I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
To leave? But, okay. I get it. You want some kind of proof that we're not just, what?
Imposters.
Mm-hmm. 10 points, Natasha. We're not imposters, we're the real thing. I'm sorry if I'm coming on kind of strong. It's my personality. You know what I mean? God, how do you prove that you know somebody? Let's see. Where do I start? Do I start with Joe or Sandy? You know, she made him get these new hotshot snow chains for the car. This is so Sandy. No imagination, but always thinking ahead. So rational. Listen, I'm sorry we barged in on you like this. Maybe we should leave, but hey, are you really gonna turn out two freezing strangers back into the storm? Neil, you're the guy who inflicted torturama on the world, more killings per square frame than any movie in history. You're pouring blood in the aisles, man. Don't tell me you're scared. What are you scared of? What am I going to do to you, huh? If I was going to do something to you, you've done it already. Wouldn't I? So do we leave or do we stay? Have a heart, Neil.
Well, we can't turn you out in this weather.
Turn them out, Neil.
Honey,
Turn them out.
The blizzard out there, honey.
Your wife is really sweet. Really. She's such a doll.
You know, with so much snow, it's like we're in a murder mystery here.
Natasha adores Agatha Christie. You know what I hate about murder mysteries? It's that everyone's got a secret. People don't have secrets. People are open books. I don't know you personally, Neil, but just from looking at you, I'd say you're probably the kind of guy who likes to make lists, for example. Lines his pencils up on his desks. Likes things neat and tidy, am I right? A Jack Daniels before bed kind of guy. You're not the kind of guy who, secretly worked for the CIA once upon a time. You're not the kind of guy with a secret history of killing people. I mean, really killing people. Off screen. You don't have any real blood on your hands. You're in the entertainment industry. You have nothing to hide.
Send them away, Neil.
And Jenny. She probably made her usual dinner for tonight. Let's see, what would it be? Pork loin and some kind of special potato recipe and a cherry rhubarb pie. For dessert. The perfect American housewife. Nothing to conceal. I'm sorry, that's the personality of mine. Again, I'm brash, I'm insensitive, I'm loud. Call me American.
You know, I have a gun in the house.
That's rich. What a liar. I have a gun in the house. Right. That's so cute. This isn't a movie. This is real life, Neil. And I'm your brother for the night. I'm a stand-in for Joe. Remember me? Your brother?
Where are Joe and Sandy?
They're very sick in bed is where they are.
What have you done with them?
They can't move is where they are. Aren't I your brother, Neil? Come on. Aren't I your brother?
Sure.
Am I your brother? Am I your brother? Am I your brother?
You're my brother.
There. You see? How hard was that? Now we can talk about all those kids we used to beat up in third grade. Just like old times. Well, brother, what do you say? We're here for the duration. You gonna play good host or what?
Shall we go into dinner?
Attaboy.
You know what I love about murder mysteries? It's that everything in them seems to mean something. The people in murder mysteries are living in a significant world. Everything holding its breath, waiting. The air is electric and then bang! It happens! The irrevocable, whatever that is. Changing everything. It's a kind of poetry. To me, it's almost a religious feeling.
I don't want any more fucking significance. I don't want it. I don't want it.
Oh, poor Jenny. Afraid over nothing. Why?
You have the wrong people.
Oh. You're the right people. You're Neil and Jenny. We're just here for dinner with you. And you have nothing to be afraid of. Really. Absolutely nothing.
Neil! Neil! Neil!
Absolutely nothing.
Jill, are you there?
Yes, I'm here. Can you see me?
No, not yet. Oh my gosh, I'm so glad we're doing this now instead of at the meeting. I want to have the bugs worked out before then.
Sure. Can you see me now?
No. Did you click your camera on?
Yes, I clicked my camera on. Well, I thought I did. Hold on. There.
No.
Oh, damn it.
Oh, what'd you do?
I pulled the Band-Aid off the camera. You know Jack, he's always worried that someone is watching him.
He put a Band-Aid on the camera?
Yeah, don't get me started.
Oh gosh, how are the kids? How are they making out with homeschooling?
They're holding up. You know, kids and technology, it's like fish to water. They miss their classes, but I'm sure it'll only be for a little while. How have you been? Is everybody healthy at your place?
Oh, yes, we're all good here. And the kids are coming home from college. They're going to complete the semester online.
Hmm.
Yeah. So today, look, I just wanted to touch base with the team to see how everyone's holding up.
Yeah.
And also at 11:15, IT's going to be joining us.
Faller? Is he presenting?
Yeah, it'll be fine.
Okay, if you it'll say be fine. So.
Yeah.
You remember what he did to Carol's hard drive?
Yeah, that's hard to forget. But listen, don't worry. It's going to be fine. And then after him, Mr. Wilcox might be making a brief statement.
Ooh, the CEO himself. All right, sounds good.
You know, I know it's a really big challenge working from home, especially for people with children. So I just wanted to hear from everyone to figure out how we can all benefit from working at home.
It sounds like a plan.
So are you ready? You know, listen, I'm going to grab some coffee before we jump into the meeting.
Yeah, I might grab a bite to eat. Bye.
Okay. See you soon.
Oh. Hey.
Wow. Hi, everybody.
Hello. Hello.
How are you all today on our very first Zoom meeting?
Wonderful.
Okay, I guess.
Oh, it's really good to see you guys. But I'm not seeing everyone.
No, me neither.
I think it's Tilly.
Tilly, are you with us?
I'm here. I can see you. Can't you see me?
No.
Nope, not at all.
Not here.
I think I know what it is. If you just...
You don't have a Band-Aid on your camera, do you?
Why would I have a Band-Aid on my camera?
Oh, never mind.
Tilly, do you see your status bar?
Well, what's that?
The shiny red button.
Where? Wait, yes, I see it.
There should be next to your mute button a video button. Do you see it?
Yes.
Click it.
The one with the camera?
Yeah.
Oh, there she is.
Hi.
Oh, there we all are. Oh my gosh, it's so good to see everyone again. Oh, how are you all doing? You know, I don't know how I look to you here on Zoom, but I just see all of you like it's the beginning of the Brady Bunch. But I'm just going to start with Liz. Let's start with you.
Yeah, I've been busy. I've been okay. I've been busy with school and with work, so.
Oh, how's school going? Has your college gone remote online?
Yeah, it has.
And how's it working for you?
I don't like it. I mean, classes are on Zoom now. It works, but it's just being there now. And now school is talking about doing something called hybrid classes. God only knows what that is. I don't know. Something will click and we'll all start getting back to normal, right?
Oh, my kids are on their way home from college, too. They're in the same boat that you are.
Yeah, maybe next semester we'll be back.
I don't know, but I do know that your Zoom skills are going to be on point. So I might have to talk to you later about how we can streamline meetings like this.
What was that? What?
That sound?
I heard it, too.
Well, whatever it was, I don't hear it now. How about work, Liz? I've read your reports. You're doing a fine job considering the circumstances.
Thanks, Anne. It's just weeks I'm really gonna miss work. I miss the parking lot. I miss our building. I miss my huge room. All my files are there. The copier, the stationery closet, my friends.
I do too, Liz. Oh my gosh, you're not alone. But we'll be talking about that in a few minutes, so hang in there. We're in this together, literally. So let's see. Carol, how are you holding up?
Well,
hey, you want a grilled cheese sandwich?
Yeah, I'll take one.
Gotcha.
Sorry.
Tilly, you can use the mute button on your control panel if you need to talk to someone without us knowing.
Where's that at?
It's to the left of your camera button. It's the same taskbar I showed you before.
Oh, I see it. Thanks.
Yeah. Carol, how are you holding up?
Great. School moved online and I couldn't be happier. Well, maybe if I had a grilled cheese sandwich.
So, you like going to college from home?
Absolutely. Mm. I wish I took that option when I started. Distractions are cut to a minimum. I can study, write, do research all from my keyboard right here in my room. Truth be told, I feel the same way about being at work. I'm more productive here than at our office.
Really? Oh, hush, Maisie, Najee, Mommy's in a meeting. Yes, she is. Oh, I'm sorry, everyone.
Hey, it's their home too.
Yeah.
Aw, I love dogs.
I'm sorry, everyone. So what were you saying, Carol?
Yes, I love working from home, and for the same reasons, no distractions. I don't have to wait at the copier if the waiver and quality department is printing out a mountain of TPS reports. I don't have to hear about the love lives of the accounting department in the break room. It's been great. As I said, I'm more productive right here.
Don't you miss socializing with friends, having a routine?
Friends. It's work. I don't have friends.
Really?
Hey, thanks.
Okay, look, I don't mean you guys. You know what I mean. Look, Liz, do you know the name of the person in cube 038?
Who's here? Where's that?
That is two rows of cubes from your aisle.
Oh, wait, don't tell me. Sally?
No, she's in cube 412.
But aren't there two... Sally's?
Okay, yes, I can confirm. There are two Sally's, and no, this is not a trick question. Do you see my point? I don't look to work for my social life. It's work. Again, I can do all of that right here with just a few keystrokes.
So, hypothetically, you don't mind working from home long term?
Not in the least.
Fair enough. Well, I'm glad to hear that you've adapted to this new way of working so quickly, Carol.
I'm just fortunate that it works for me. Less distractions.
So, Kelly, how about you? How are you doing?
Me? I'm doing fine. No complaints. My little brothers are a pain, but...
Bring back pheasant!
Even if they weren't a pain.
Bring back pheasant!
Oh, I'm sorry. They're having a disagreement.
What is going on?
Homeschooling.
See this right here? This is why I don't want children.
Helen, what do you mean?
They're doing their assignment. What is your favorite state bird? Oh my gosh. Okay, enough. Take this to the cellar.
The cellar?
God only knows what lurks in the cellar.
The cellar! It's almost time for your history, your Zoom class. Your very future depends on it.
Oh, Mom.
Come on, Tim.
Just go. Shut the door. Do you know how many states have a cardinal as their state bird?
Seven.
Seven.
Correct.
Now, how did you guys know that?
Little brothers, one of mine is in the same class as Tom.
Oh. That's my granddaughter.
So, Helen, how are you holding up?
Oh, well, I find homeschooling quite fulfilling.
Do you have any tips on making a workspace at home?
Do you have a cellar?
Is somebody chewing something? That sound is driving me crazy.
Sounds like your misophonia is acting up.
What's that?
Google it.
There it is again. Who's doing that?
Well, I thought it was a Zoom thing. Guys, speaking of which, our IT department is going to be popping in soon.
A guy who wiped my hard drive?
Yep, that's the guy.
Listen, I invited him here just in case we had any questions for him concerning Zoom or networking issues that we might have with the company's encryption system. Guys, I'm sorry, everyone. Mommy's still in a meeting. Good to sob. Oh, I'm sorry, everyone. Hey, Kelly, is that behind you?
Oh, the green screen.
Yeah, the green screen. And you can project background images onto that?
Yeah, anything. I've got a couple here. We got this one. Wow. Very nice. Christmas-themed one. And my personal favorite.
Good one. Now I have whiplash.
I may have to show that to the boys.
Well, we might be able to use this in the future.
We could.
Can you show us how to use this?
Absolutely.
Nice.
I think Balor's in the waiting room. Let's put a pin in on the green screen now, and we'll talk. Okay, Kelly?
Got it.
Mr. Fowler. Are you there?
What is he trying to say?
His lips are moving, but he's not saying anything.
I'm not going to say it. I'm not going to say it.
Mr. Fowler!
Mr. Fowler! We can't hear you! We can't hear you!
Thanks for having me. Any questions? Hey, what's that?
Yeah, I've got a question for you. Why do you have all that toilet paper?
I saw possible shortages and went on several reconnaissance missions.
You're the reason I can't find toilet paper?
Fowler, my family, we've been using coffee filters.
Coffee filters?
Yes. Thank God for origami. It was one of the kids' lessons. Very handy.
I will never look at a paper swan the same way again.
Wow.
Okay, guys, enough. Mr. Fowler, can you help us with pointers for using Zoom?
Zoom, huh?
Yes, Zoom. We've spent the morning getting used to interacting on the computer when we used to interact in our boardroom. So I wondered if you had any tips that might be useful to us now that our boardroom is going to be virtual for the foreseeable future.
Wait, really? How much longer are we talking?
Well, Helen, we might be working from home for quite some time. I was hoping to see how everyone was doing and to see if we could pull our thoughts together on how we could best do that.
So we don't know when we're going back to the office.
No, we do not. And it's really impossible to say.
Yes!
No!
Hey, I think I might have something that can help.
Oh!
My granddaughter showed me how to do this. Did you know you could do this? Huh? How cute is that?
Anne, will there be any openings in the IT department anytime soon? I may be interested.
Mr. Fowler, thank you so much for your time. If we have any questions, we'll be in contact. Does that sound okay with the rest of the team?
Yes, absolutely. 100%.
Hey, fair enough. If you have any questions, you know where to find this waskity wabbit.
And that's all, folks.
Wow.
That is how hard drives get wiped.
Oh, guys, Mr. Wilcox is in the waiting lounge, and he just wants to briefly touch base with us about where we are and where we're going. Mr. Wilcox, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Oh, I was
just...
I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry.
You were saying something?
You go.
I'm good.
Now, Mr. Wilcox.
Thank you. I won't keep you from your meeting for too long, but I wanted to thank each and every one of you on the team for your unceasing ability to adapt to these times. During this time, we will continue to use science and data to guide our decisions. Oh, one of those decisions is that we will be working at home for the foreseeable future. I know this may be a hardship, but I know that we will come out on the other side of this storm stronger and more efficient than we ever were. The status quo is off the table.
Here's your grilled cheese sandwich.
Thanks, honey. Oh my God. You might want to put on some pants.
Hilly!
What? I'm on mute!
No, you're not!
Oh.
These are strange days. These are uncharted waters with a storm raging on all sides of us. But we are stronger than the times we find ourselves in. There has been uncertainty about our future. Will we be here? Will we have jobs? I am here to tell you that we will be holding all jobs for the rest of fiscal year 2020. We will hold on to jobs into and through the end of fiscal year 2021 as well. We must constantly evaluate our situation, but there will be no job cuts. We will cut budgets and see what aid the federal government is going to provide, but our employment profile will remain intact. We don't hurt our own people, especially when they are down. Thank you, each and every one of you, for your contribution to the success of this organization. Thank you for letting me join you this morning.
Thank you, Mr. Wilcox.
Oh, thank you, Anne. Oh, and your team. You all stay safe now.
So, there we have it. What will the future bring? I really can't say. I can only speak for right now. But what I can say is we will be working from home until otherwise specified. But there'll be no job loss at this time. There might be budget cuts, but our workforce should remain in place. Jill, do you have any further business for today?
No.
Does anyone have any questions?
No.
All right, then. I consider this first Zoom meeting a success. We'll work out the Zoom bugs as time goes on, and I'll see you guys in, how about 2 weeks?
Yeah, sounds good to me.
Sure, sounds good.
Yeah.
Okay, excellent. I'll send out the invites, and if you guys need me for anything, I'm only an email or a phone call away. Goodbye, everybody. Stay safe.
Bye, guys.
Oh, my God.
It was you all this time?
Oh, sorry about the noise, everyone. I didn't realize how sensitive this microphone is.
Now I'm hungry.
See everyone.
Yeah, see ya. Stay safe.
Take care, guys. I have to go check the basement. It's quiet. Too quiet. Hey, hon, can I get another grilled cheese?
Hi, everybody.
Hey.
Great job, everybody.
Bye. Take care.
So much fun. Thank you for joining us.
Yes. So much fun.
Good to see you all.
Bye.
Thanks for coming tonight.
Have a good night, everyone.
Have a good night.
Take care. Thanks for coming.
Thanks all.